વિરુભાઈ વિડિયો યોગ્ય છે?
ના, એ જ કરો સ્પોટલાઇટ.
ઓકે ઓકે,
ધેટ્સ ફાઇન. બધાને જય જીનેન્દ્ર અને જય શ્રી કૃષ્ણ. આજે આપણા ગેસ્ટ છે હિનાબેન મોદી. હિનાબેન, વેલકમ. અને નવજીવન વડીલ કેન્દ્ર તરફથી તમારું સ્વાગત છે. આઈ વિલ ઇન્ટ્રોડ્યુસ હિનાબેન ફર્સ્ટ. એમણે મને નાઇસ ડિટેલ મોકલી છે, બહુ સરસ છે. સીઝન એમ્બેસેડર ઓફ વેગનિઝમ. તમે વિગન ફૂડ વિશે તો બધા જાણો જ છો. હા, તો નોટ ઓનલી સી બિલીવ્સ ઇન વિગનિઝમ, સી પ્રેક્ટિસિસ, અને આપણને કંઈક આજે બતાવશે હાઉ હેલ્ધી ઇટ ઇઝ. આપણા જૈન પ્રિન્સિપલ પ્રમાણે, હિન્દુ પ્રિન્સિપલ પ્રમાણે, ઇટ્સ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. સો સી ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ શો અસ ક્વાઇટ અ ફ્યુ થિંગ્સ એન્ડ હોપફુલી ટીચ અસ અબાઉટ વિગનિઝમ. સી હેલ્પ્સ પીપલ મેક ધ શિફ્ટ ટુવર્ડ્સ અ પ્લાન્ટ બેઝડ ડાયટ, વિગન લાઇફસ્ટાઈલ ઓર બોથ. હેવિંગ બીન એ વિગન ફોર ઓવર 13 યર્સ, 13 વર્ષથી તો તમે વિગન છો, એને ફોર ડેકેડ્સ, અને વેજીટેરિયન ઓફકોર્સ. Heena has lived the experience and message that she shares. Heena will bring compassion and practical insight into the topic of going plant-based and staying plant-based, as well as going beyond food, showing how easy embracing a vegan lifestyle can be. As a qualified school teacher and natural health practitioner, Heena will help you bust myths, address common obstacles, and find a meaningful, simple, and personalized approach that works for you. Any website che plantshift.com e hu pachhi lakhu chu. To Heenaben, welcome in Navjeevan Varil Kendra, and let's begin. Yeah,
sure, you can. Thank you.
Share.
Hi everyone. I'm going to share my screen. અને હું મિક્સ ગુજરાતી અને ઇંગ્લિશમાં બોલીશ, અને કાંઈ ન ફાવતું હોય તો મને જણાવજો. જસ્ટ અ સેકન્ડ. વન્ડરફુલ. ઓકે, સો ટુડે ઓવરઓલ ઇન ધ ટોક આઈ એમ હોપિંગ ટુ ઇન્સ્પાયર એન્ડ પ્રોમ્પ્ટ રિફ્લેક્શન. Inspire strength, increase your confidence, help you make conscious decisions. So rather than like oge oge ke vichar vagar, instead of that, vichar karine decisions levana, implementing positive changes, reducing duality. I think duality in shabd is dvand. Etle like, you know, like be vichar chalta hoy juda juda ke vichar mai vastu ne આચરણમાં બીજું એ બધું રિડ્યુસ કરવા, સો ધેટ વી આર મોર અલાઇન્ડ એન્ડ ઇન્ક્રીઝિંગ પીસ ઓફ માઇન્ડ. સો ધેટ ઓવરઓલ ઇઝ વોટ વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ કવર. યા, ધેટ્સ કેરી ઓન. ઓકે, સો ડેફિનેશન્સ. સો આઈ નો વિનોદ અંકલ સેડ તમને બધાને વિગન ખાવાનું ખબર હશે. આઈ એમ નોટ શ્યોર ઇફ યુ નો ધ ડિફરન્સ બિટવીન પ્લાન્ટ બેઝડ, વિગન, લેક્ટો ઓવો વેજીટેરિયન્સ એન્ડ વેજીટેરિયન્સ. So often, you know, gana gujarati kahe ke I'm a pure vegetarian. So when they say that, they mean that they don't eat meat or fish or whatever, but they also don't eat eggs. So that's lacto-ovo vegetarians. That's like the proper name for it. And then vegetarians, the definition of vegetarian would mean that they can eat eggs or might eat eggs. Plant-based means that you don't consume animal products. So it would be vegetarian, but also no eggs, no honey, no dairy, anything that comes from an animal, basically. And then vegan is taking it beyond the mouth. It's everything that you do and everything you may wear. So for example, makeup, hair products, cleaning products, clothes, jewelry, all those things. Vegan means like living a vegan lifestyle. Are they healthy? The reason I put that as a thing to mention is because a lot of people think that going plant-based And they often say plant-based or vegan, and they mean it in the same way, but the difference, but a lot of people will say plant-based or they'll say vegan and they mean it in the same way, they're talking about food. So being vegan or plant-based doesn't necessarily mean you're healthy, because with any diet you can eat junk food, you can overeat. There is a way to be healthy and plant-based and healthy and vegan, but that needs to be something that people consciously do. Just like as a vegetarian, you could eat mitai all day long and lots of things that are just fatty and not good for you and not have a balanced diet. So in the same way how we can be unhealthy vegetarians, we can also be unhealthy vegans and plant-based people. So I hope that makes sense. Do people shift between them? Yes. Yeah, so there's a title called flexitarians. So there are some people, one day they might eat meat, another day they may be plant-based, another day they might be vegetarian. They kind of just shift between the various diets, if you like, and they're open with that. They're honest about it. So that's another term for you to know. So with veganism, positively contagious. So there's a charity called Veganuary. It's vegan and January put together to make Veganuary. So it was a campaign to help people go vegan in the month of January. And then obviously they would encourage people to carry on being vegan or plant-based. But it was like a way to, after Christmas, when people have had a lot of indulgence and they might want to detox and have more simple food, and also New Year, you might reflect and think, oh, my life bad level. So things like that, it would all come into play. So you can see from 2014 all the way to 2018, and I know it's not up to date, but you can see the increase, the spike. So that's how that spike has continued rising. So that's been really good. Some of the reasons that people go vegan include the planet. So livestock accounts for 14.5% of human-induced greenhouse emissions. That's a lot. 20% of the Amazon has been cut down since 1970 to make space for livestock grazing and feed. Cattle rearing generates more greenhouse emissions than the transportation sector. And agriculture, primarily meat and dairy, accounts for 70% of freshwater consumption. So if you imagine, kada ek tame mas nahi khata ho, pan tame dairy khata ho, so to e meat ne dairy be connected che, because the meat industry impregnates their cows, and then the calves are taken for meat or leather if they're boys, or if they're male calves, and if they're females, they're kept for the dairy industry, and all of that requires water and produces gas and all the rest of it. So imagine if we went plant-based or vegan, even if it was for one meal in the week or one day in the week, how much of a positive impact that would have, right? So that's some of the reasons there. And then there's some facts here, which I can send to Vinodanga later to share with you, because the text is quite small. But roughly speaking, 72% of the people who participate in Veganuary stay vegan. There's over 400,000 participants. 60% said it's easier than expected. 93% said they'd likely to try vegan again. 98% said they recommend it. So it's quite positive. Okay, so some of the reasons for why people go with vegan. Vajan utarwa, to increase improve their health, especially for people who have diabetes, blood pressure, Crohn's disease. They're some of the health conditions that people go plant-based or vegan for in order to improve it, or even actually some people say they can reverse it. Preventing certain health conditions. For the planet, which we've talked about already, for animal welfare, which I won't go into in too much detail. I'm not into sharing horrible graphic stories, but you can imagine, like the cow is held captive, it's trapped, it's forced to become pregnant, and then the butcher's taken away from them so that we can have the milk. So that's the animal welfare side. And that's just dairy. I mean, with chickens and eggs and honey and bees and silk and silkworms and all of that, the story is similar. The details are different, but it's still captivity and hurting them, really. Allergies and intolerances. Lots of people are actually intolerant to dairy, but they don't know it. They carry on having it and they have symptoms, but they don't realize, que dairy le deche. And then when they stop dairy, they suddenly feel less bloated, or their eczema clears up, or they feel their skin's better, or they might have irritable bowel syndrome and that reduces or actually goes away. So a number of people are actually intolerant to it and don't realize, which is quite amazing. Some people go vegan or plant-based to be minimalistic. So, you know, in Jainism, we talk about aparigraha and reducing lots of things, not just possessions, but even internally, the ashakti we have towards things. So this helps with that. It's a minimalist thing. Reducing negative input into the mind and body. So the reason that might sound like it's a bit weird, if you imagine, so this isn't very nice, but it's not graphic. If you imagine this female cow has had her baby and the baby is literally taken away from her within minutes or hours. So imagine the stress that goes through her system when that's happening, and that would all go into the milk and then we would have it. The same way for meat, if when the cow or any animal is being taken to be killed, it's stressed, it knows, under it knows that something bad is going to happen to it, and all of that goes into its energy. And the way you could relate to this is, if you imagine one day you're making some food and tamara mood sarunathi gusto aibo ke tamai ekdam jaldi macho ne, you know, your mind is not right, and the food, does it turn out the way it normally turns out, or is it different in a negative way? Because I've realized when I've not been in the right frame of mind and I've made food, it hasn't been as good as it should have been. In fact, it's actually been not very good. So that shows how my energy and my mood kind of transferred itself into the food. That's the kind of best way I can try and explain it. Other people go vegan for performance and recovery. So athletes, boxers, people who have had certain operations and they need to recover. Well, everyone needs to recover, but they want to recover faster, better. They go vegan or plant-based for that. Also peace of mind, and the dvanda I mentioned earlier, reducing duality by increasing the alignment between our thoughts and our behavior. Let me know if I'm going too fast, by the way. Okay, so I'm going to stop sharing my screen because I want to see everyone. I'm just getting the questions right. Hold on one second. So I'm going to do gallery view. Okay, I'm going to go put which here. So your gut response, okay? So not thinking, just really immediate response. If you can put your videos on just for this bit, I would really appreciate it, because I'm going to get you to do a thumbs up or thumbs down or something. So what's your gut response without overthinking it? Does going plant-based or vegan have a positive or negative impact on the environment? Yes, no, not sure. Can you show me with your thumbs? Yes, no, or not sure. Okay, I've got a few videos coming on. Okay, good. I'm going to ask you a few more questions, so just bear with me. Would living a vegan lifestyle save animals from captivity, harm, and death? Yes, no, or I don't know. Okay, cool. I'm just flicking through to see if anyone else has turned their video on. Okay. Would this shift have a positive or negative impact on you and yours? You meaning you and yours meaning your friends, family. Yes to positive or no to positive or not sure. Okay. Cool. And does going plant-based improve our physical health? Yes. No, not sure. Okay, two more. Can going vegan have a positive impact on our emotional well-being? Yes, no, not sure. Okay, and last one, is performance and recovery improved when our diet is plant-based?
Oh, plant-based, yes.
Okay, cool. Thank you. All right, I'm gonna change the view back and share my screen again. Okay. So those questions I'm gonna ask you again later. That's why I wanted this quick gut response now, your instinct and feelings rather than logical analysis. After sharing various things, I'm gonna ask you them again. So that's why we did that. Okay, so nutrition. I'm going to cover a bit about nutrition as well. It might seem a bit weird, but it's quite important and connected. So what's important for a healthy body and mind? So I strongly believe that we should enjoy food and we should make it work for us, okay? So eating and suffering reactions because of intolerances or because we comfort eat to soothe the mind when we're feeling troubled or upset or whatever, which then plagues the body, or undereating and not functioning, because some of us undereat when we want to control the situation or when we want to lose weight in an unhealthy way. That means we then don't function, and that's not good for us either. Also, eating food that depletes us, that instead of nourishing us, it depletes our energy. Or eating stuff that doesn't give us enough of what we need. All of that can be remedied without losing the enjoyment of eating. So turning all of that around, eating food that doesn't cause any negative reaction, coming out of comfort eating, making sure we eat enough but not too much, making sure we eat the right foods, all of that can be done without us thinking, oh, I don't want to eat, this is boring food. Yeah, we can do it in a way that is still pleasurable. And that's really important, because all of these things affect our mood and how well we feel and how motivated we are. So that's why I'm covering that. So the triad of good health and well-being. If the body is given the right fuel and conditions, it's empowered to heal itself. So imagine just like a car, if it's diesel, right? And you can't, the engine might work for a little bit and they're just going to break down and we'll have to remove the fuel and everything else. So it's the same with the body. If we have the right fuel and conditions, it will be in the best situation it needs to be in to heal itself. It can regenerate, rejuvenate, and rebuild. Also, the immune system will be powerful enough to defend the body against invaders. And we've been talking a lot about the immune system over the last couple of years because of COVID. So that's another thing to bear in mind. But for the above to happen, we need the mind, body, and spirit to be at their best. So there's this model, I call it SEDACE. Some people say SDACE, but that's very long for me, so I say SEDACE. So the D stands for digestion, where the food is broken down so that it can be absorbed, right? That it's broken down and the other bits we'll get to later. So then the A is absorption. That's the food is absorbed and it's there to nourish the cells and do everything that it needs to do. And then the C in SEDACE is for circulation. So that enables the blood to transport the absorbed nutrients all around the cells and move all around the body and get to where it needs to get to. And then the last bit is the E, which is the elimination. So that's the elimination. The cells need their waste removed to function. Otherwise, the cells won't work properly. So elimination is really important. So all of these things are important. Now, I would like to ask you to respond to me in the chat. So we've discussed the DACE, D-A-C-E, digestion, absorption, circulation, and elimination. We haven't discussed the S. So if I can give you literally just 10 seconds to write in the chat, what do you think the S stands for?
Yes.
S, mm-hmm. The S in SEDACE. What does it mean? What does it stand for? So we've covered the DACE, digestion, and all the rest of it. Yeah, so if someone's written substance, great. Anyone else? Whatever this S is, it affects the other four. It affects the digestion, absorption, circulation, and elimination. I'm gonna give you 7 more seconds.
Yes. Sangsta.
Six. Sugar, good. Five. Sustainability, four.
Marilakuche.
Three. Two. One. Okay, I'm going to go back to the screen share. Okay, so the S actually stands for stress. I shouldn't have gone back to the screen share because I want to actually ask you a question. So hands up or thumbs up if you think stress will affect DACE. Thumbs down if you think it won't affect it, and this way if you're not sure. Okay, cool. So most of the thumbs I'm seeing are up. So you think stress will affect digestion, absorption, circulation, and elimination.
Yes, yes.
Okay. I'm going back to screen share. Well done, though, guys. It definitely does. Yeah, it's a big thing. So the consequences of stress, fear. So stress is one word, and you know we know them. We know the same word in different ways. So stress, fear, worry, anxiety, discontent, all those things are different levels of stress, you could say, or different levels of discomfort where the mind isn't happy, right? So that can cause lots of things. For example, gastric ulcers, excess of stomach acid or not enough stomach acid. It can inhibit secretions of mucus, which protects the stomach and the duodenal wall from hydrochloric acid, which is ulcers. It can suppress the immune system and many more things. And all of those things will affect our mood and our mental health. So this is why, stress, being aware of it and being able to handle it is really important. So stress and the choice of food. So can you just think about this for yourself? Make a note on your phone or on a piece of paper or mental note is fine. It's just for you. You don't have to share with me. Love. When you're stressed, what do you drink or eat?
Okay.
So if you can maybe just think back to the last time where you felt pressured or you felt stressed, is there something different that you eat or drink when you feel that way? And then the other part of the question is, how do you feel after you've eaten or drank those things? So for example, I know people who, when they're stressed, they eat sugary foods and sugary drinks. So they don't eat proper food, let's call it that just for the sake of simplicity. It's basically dessert all day long. Now, that's definitely going to have an ulcer on the body, and it's not nutritional, right? It's not a balanced diet, but that's what happens. And then depending on how often they are stressed, that could then become a cycle of just eating and putting on weight and all the rest of it. I think someone needs to mute maybe. I can hear some people talking and like, it might be distracting for
Mute, please.
Okay, so this thing I was talking about is comfort food. So for example, when you feel down, you might have a certain food or a certain drink to pick you up. So that might be coffee, tea, or biscuits, or tarelanasta, or I don't know, whatever it is, cake, anything. So what that does, so you have an instant high, but then what happens when you have that high? It doesn't stay there. You crash, right? As the food, the asar of the food wears off, you crash. Oh no, bashu crash. And that's what happens. So we keep doing that to our body when we feel that way. And that's not good for anyone. It's not good for our mental health. It's not good for the sharir. But the other thing some people do is when they're upset, they don't eat. So there's lots of different reasons for that. Some people do it because So some people, when they're upset, other people, either one is an extreme. It's not good for the body, right? So that's why we're talking about that. It's all connected. So can you spot a connection? Think back to the food and drink you usually have, And even think about the food and drink, you deliberately avoid them. And then think about which one affects your mood in some way, whether it's negative, positive, whether it makes you faster, makes you slower, any type of usar. And again, you don't need to share this. It's just, this is the reflection type of thing that I want you to kind of reflect on what you eat and drink and what kind of impact it has on you. So for example, do you need caffeine before you can function in the morning? Like a lot of people I know say to me, So that shows a clear effect. Other people say, throughout the day, and so what happens when they come off those things? What happens when they stop having that caffeine or that sugary food or whatever it is? So it's just for us to be aware, okay? Just for us to be aware. Physical stress. Now, do you think physical stress can... let me ask that again. Do you think food can create physical stress on the body? And I am going to ask you to do the thumbs up thing again. So, food can create a physical stress on the body. Okay, so we've got some no's. Any yeses or any maybes? Okay, cool. So, it can. And we'll go back to screen share. Here we go. So, sugar, caffeine, foods that are very salty, oily foods, fatty foods, they create a direct physical stress on the internal organs that are needed to detoxify the body. So belame ini vatkaitene in sedase, the E for elimination. So elimination, you could also say, is part of the detoxing of the body, right? It's getting rid of, detox is basically getting rid of the stuff you don't need or that isn't good for you. So having these certain foods have a negative asar on the body in terms of detoxification. So they stimulate us, they cause an imbalance to our emotional state, and they affect the internal organs. So that's something to be aware of. What about exercise? Can exercise cause an unbeneficial stress? I'm going to do thumbs up again. So can exercise be bad for you? Yes, no, maybe. Interesting. Okay, so it can be, depending on how much we do. So if you imagine, if you're not used to exercising much and you suddenly think, right, I'm going to exercise, I'm going to run a marathon within a month, so I'm going to run every day and I'm going to run this many miles or whatever. No, that's not the way to do it, because basically your body's gone from zero exercising to accelerating super fast and doing lots of exercise, which will deplete the body and it will just tire you out in a really not good way. So really, if we're not exercising, we need to build up gentle exercise and slowly increase it so that the body has time to get used to it. And that will help the body and the mind and have a positive impact on our sleeping patterns, but only if we do it in a gradual way. It let aste aste physical exercise increase karan. Okay, so then the stress, right? We talked about a little bit about the S in sedase. So stress. So I'm not gonna stop sharing and ask you for the thumbs up. I just want you to think for yourself, do you think that all stress is bad for us, or do you think some stress is okay? Just have a little think. Gut reaction. Okay, so my take on it is stress can be positive, but only if it's a little bit here and there. Continual stress, continual long-term stress, excessive stress, that's the concern. Because what that does is it means that physical reactions in the body remain active. So when we're stressed, certain things happen in the body. Anibati ame de-stress te jai, at least shant te jai. But ame stress level akko di hai hoi, the physical reactions onare, ofna te jai, in between. So basically the body is then overloaded with hormones and there's more demands on the liver, which is already probably strained. So basically the asar is not just emotional, it's also physical. So food. Connected to stress, connected to comfort eating and everything else we've been talking about, what to avoid and what to embrace. So eating processed foods, low quality foods deprives the body of what it needs, and it gives the body another job to do. So if you imagine body already thak lai ko already kitli badi vastu chalti hoy andar ane pachi ame khavanu je au low quality varu khai processed food khai, so basically it's nishfar for the body, and actually it's worse than nishfar because it doesn't nourish it, but it actually drains the energy that's needed for other things. And to we talked about the E, elimination. To eliminate heavy, fibreless foods zaps the body of energy. The energy is diverted into pushing all that food out. The immune system is deprived of energy. And it also will affect our mood. So all of this is connected. Food to embrace fiber. So eating food that provides roughage, it's like fiber kind of toima, I don't know how to explain roughage, but it basically helps move the food through and push it through. So this is about elimination. It helps us keep our bowel movements regular, and it helps make sure that je badi vastu amne grahan na karvi joye karvi hoy e badi vastu nikri jaye. It also means the time that the things that we don't need in the body, the time it stays in the body is called transit time. So that's the time between us digesting it and us eating it and it leaving the body. That transit time is reduced because if you imagine if there's waste in the body, we don't want it to stay in the body for too long, right? Jaldi kaduche. So we transit time or chuhoi, that's better. So fiber helps us make that transit time less. Refined food lacks fiber and the bowel gets clogged up and toxins stay in the body, but also something which is even worse is the waste then gets pulled back into the system and it gets reabsorbed, which is not good, right? Because vastu kadviche, but that vastu then stays in the body, which is not good. So fiber is really important. Carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are great for producing heat and energy. They are reduced to simple sugars, which is good for the brain and the nervous tissues and muscles and lots of things. But je carbohydrates ame vadhare khaine to je excess hoine, that gets turned into fat and it's stored. So that's why we want to be careful with carbohydrates. Refined carbohydrates are fiberless. They lack many of the vitamin B's and vitamin E and minerals. So for example, refined carbohydrates will go to eat omne ochi kari joik or even try not to, are sugar, syrups, polished foods. It like gana tame kadaj white rice khata ho, that's polished. It's better to have brown rice. Flour, which isn't 100% stone ground, instant grains, instant rice, powdered starch, commercial bread, refined pasta, most snacks. They are fiberless. So they are valueless and they're indigestible and they make you constipated and that transit time increases. And then sometimes we don't have what we need to push it out. So then we get it back. We need an abundance of complex carbohydrates, which is raw fruit and vegetables. That's great for us. Unless we have hyperglycemia or candida, then there's certain conditions if we have them, we shouldn't have too much of them. But generally speaking, it's better for us to have them. And all the stuff I said about rice, pasta, all that things, if you just think brown is best, so brown rice, brown pasta, brown lot, brown bread, brown is the best way to go, okay? So not white, because that's all polished and processed and refined. Okay, so protein. I know lots of people talk about protein. So protein, that can lead to acidic conditions. It can cause an excess of urea in the tissues and cause many inflammatory conditions. Insufficient protein, ochuhoito, will cause low amounts of energy, poor stamina, insufficient resistance to infection, as well as weakness, depression, and slow healing recovery, or healing or recovery. So there's a certain equation, which I can send to Vinod Uncle after, that will you look at your weight and then you have to do this thing, and then it tells you how much protein you should have minimum per day. So that's a good way to make sure you're getting enough protein. Well, you know, earlier we talked about, I covered recovery and performance. So these are some pictures of vegan athletes. So some famous ones you may know: Lewis Hamilton, British Formula One driver. He's been vegan since 2017, and he makes the headlines for his activism almost as often he does for winning races. Venus Williams, tennis, iconic tennis player. She holds countless titles, 4 Olympic gold medals, if not more, making her one of the most successful players in history. Patrick Bobomi, I don't know how to say his surname, but the strong guy, him in the, where you see there's a man in a vest top wearing a vest that says 0% meat, 100% muscle. Under him, you see a really muscly guy. That is this Patrick. So he's known as the strong man. As one of the strongest men on the planet, we think it's really safe to say that he doesn't struggle to get enough protein, and he's vegan. So, wow. And Lisa Gawthorne is the one in the middle. She's holding a weight and she's got a black cap on. She is a long-term vegan and living proof that you don't need to eat animals or animal products to stay on top of your game. So, yeah, and the others, there's so many, but I just mentioned a few. So I know some of you will be going, oh no, she's telling me not to have oil. But I don't know. I mean, you have to be motivated enough to make these changes. And I understand we're not all in the same place. We're all in a different place in the journey. So at least knowing this is one step closer to improvement. Even if you know this, knowing is better than not knowing. And then we can slowly move towards what we need to do. So we should avoid frying tadili vastu because it negatively changes the molecular structure of foods. If you can't do without oil, then use a little bit and cook it on a low temperature. I know I'm actually going to the kayuche for tama, but you can actually get these sprays of oil. So you do like 2 or 3 sprays. It's really ochu, and it's better than doing this whole teaspoon or tablespoon or whatever. Also, it's better to saute food, so fry it quickly, and doing it with water or tomato juice instead of oil. I know that sounds really weird. It tastes fine. Like, basically, I think apart from 2 dishes, I don't use oil anymore. And I've had guests over and I've made things for other people. So it's really fine, and you can experiment and I think it'll be really good. Also, alternatives to frying are grilling, baking, steaming. One thing which I know a lot of mums do, and I know that sounds stereotypical because I said mums, or let's say a lot of women do, is we use oil tarwa mate, and then we let it cool, and then baini ma bhari na ke ne pachi pachu vapre. Please em nahi karjo. Tel ek vakat vari ne feki dejo. And I know that sounds so wasteful, especially for people who, you know, have come from a difficult background and spent ages working themselves up to where they are now. And it seemed like, it's not good, but it's not good for the body either. So, yeah, I guess you have to make that call. So foods to embrace. Remember I said brown is best. So some of the things that are really good for the body: brown rice, wholemeal pasta, which is brown pasta, fruit, vegetables, whole grains, dried beans, lentils, nuts, lots of things. There's lots and lots of choice. Water. Okay, now I know there's a lot of talk about water. Kitlu piu, kyare piu, kitla vakte piu, or how often, or sarana borma piu, ke sangna. So it's not as simple as one rule fits all. So some people have it before they eat to help them not eat too much. Some people have it after they eat so they can eat more because they're underweight and they need to eat more. Other people try to avoid it before they eat, not because of the vajan issue, but because it can reduce the concentration of the stomach acid, so then that helps. The stomach acid is needed to help break food down, and if that's diluted, then you have digestive problems. Some people say, oh, first thing in the morning, or even not first thing, just one time in the day, you should just drink 1 liter all in one go. That's not good for you because the nutrients that the body wants to hold on to, they get flushed out, they're forced out in a way. So it's not good to have too much in one go. It's better to have it aste aste. If you don't like tap water, which I know that might sound a bit strange, you know, it has that chemically taste and some people don't like it. Instead of having tap water, I'm going to stop sharing just so you can see this. This is a charcoal stick. So basically you can buy them online. You can get one or you can get like six. There's no expiry date and it basically filters the water. So in this jug or whatever you have, I put the tap water and I put the charcoal stick and it filters the water naturally. It's really, really good. And I'll send Vinod Uncle an article I've got about that, which will explain more rather than taking up the time now. But yeah, they're really good. So that's a good way to have filtered water without having Brita filters and plastic and all that kind of thing. The mind. So remember we talked about the triad, the mind, the body, the spirit. So we need to find ways to relax and quieten the mind. Okay, so that will help us maintain calmness and eat well. So some of the things you can do are things like yoga, dhyan, meditation, also kind of looking back on your life and thinking about any emotional stresses that might show themselves physically. If we don't treat it, we don't find a way to let go of it. So that's something that you probably can't do on your own and you would need counseling for that. And that's not something that I think anyone should be ashamed of. I actually wanted to share a story about that, but I think we're actually going to be, I'm not going to have enough time. So let's just keep going and then we'll see if we've got time after. But emotional support, ways to help you with stress and releasing it and talking things through, friends, family. The Samaritans, which is a free helpline. You can call it for free and they help with emotional issues. Your GP, counselling, hypnotherapy. There's also a thing called IAPT, I-A-P-T. And if you just Google that, you can refer yourself for online counselling, which is really good. So you don't even need to go and see the GP or go and talk to anyone. You can just do it yourself. Okay, so far we have talked about what eating the wrong food can do, how it can make us feel physically unwell, how it can stimulate us, how we can then crash, how we become dependent on certain foods and drink, how it can affect our mood when we don't get that food and drink, how it can make us feel excited briefly, you know, when we have that acceleration and then we crash, which we talked about, how it can drain and divert our energy, which is needed to do other things in the body, but it gets forced to go and do with these things. And we've also looked at the need to minimize physical and emotional stress as well, and how to gradually increase physical exercise. And we've talked about ways to finding ways to calm the mind and deal with emotional stresses. Okay, so they're the things we've kind of covered so far. Depending on your personality and the level of motivation you have, that will determine how easy it is for you to change eating habits and how easy it is for you to find someone to help you with any emotional things that are weighing you down. And that's just fine. That we're all at a different pace in our journey and we need to do what we can. So these are some of the things that I do to keep my mind, body and spirit at their best. So I went dairy-free, then plant-based and then vegan since 2008. For me, that's good because I'm abstaining from a system that causes harm and death to animals. So hinsama, like in this way, yeah, it reduces hinsa and brings me peace of mind. I have harmony between what I think and do, and that makes me feel more honest and more happy. So that I mean dwandi vat kahi thi. So marman ma em hoy ke mane kai bija jeev ne dukh nathi apu, par pachi u dairy ke mask ke kai khao to that doesn't make sense. So mane pachi khabar pare ke marman ne mar acharan ni andar ferfar che. So that's not sarar, right? So this brings me closer to being sarar and gives me a sense of happiness. I also eat well and have a huge choice of food. It reduces my involvement in things that are destructive to the planet, all the things that we talked about at the beginning. I feel healthier. I had issues with my digestive system and I didn't even know that it was being caused by dairy, and it was, and it, that reduced, so that's great. Minimalism, we talked about before. So for me, that feels liberating. Like, supermarket, my job, when it comes to aki, I'm my job, it's like great. I'm really happy with that. And I had do daily meditation and singing. I love bhakti. So that really is a great way to help the mind and yeah, be positive. So some obstacles. So some of you might say, oh no, I can't go plant-based because I can't do without tasty food. Me neither. Mane food board garage here. There are fruit, vegetables, grains, rice, vegan cheese, vegan cream, vegan milk, vegan yogurt, and so much more. Vegan cakes, so much more. Some people say, nah, I can't do it because I'm sporty and I work out. But there are a number of vegan athletes who I've showed you already. Some people will say, nah, but mane bare kawabogame. Me too. And it is amazing the amount of restaurants that either have a vegan menu or they have vegan items on the menu, but they're unmarked. So that's why I said ask and you'll be surprised, because I'm a butcher, but she gets it, oh, vegan chair, vegan chair, vegan chair. Other menus, other restaurants have menus with everything in one menu, so it will be marked vegan. And others will say to you, oh, we can make any of these things, but we can just change it to veganize it. So it's very cool. It's not hard like it was in 2008 when I went vegan, when a lot of people didn't know what it meant. Now it's just so good, so easy. And if you think you can't go vegan because you love dessert, I love dessert. And I have a sweet tooth. So it's not hard at all. I make desserts and I gift desserts and yeah, they're lovely. So So vegan lifestyle, shopping and well-being, right? So we talked about the mun earlier and the triad of the health, the spirit and the mind. So vegan lifestyle, remember that's beyond food. So that's everything else that you buy with your wallet. And shopping and well-being, the way they're connected is, imagine if you buy something silk and you know that it's made by killing silkworms. Inside, if you have the belief in hinsa na karu joy, because that's prominent in Hinduism and Jainism, then under tamne kai thase ke o me asilk ni vastu lidi ke o vaprushu ne ma to bodu hinsa thai. The same thing when you might feel judged if someone notices that you're wearing suede shoes, because if we believe in ahinsa, then suede shoes comes it's animal skin, so that doesn't really work, does it? That dwand is there, that duality. Do you feel misaligned when you remember that your furniture is made of leather? So again, like, you know, you might be thinking, oh, under kai kuch to aise ke o mera leather ni vastu le di, or you know, or you might feel unsettled when you reflect on the fact that you have a coat and it's got fur on it. And do I know ke satu fur che ke kotu che manat khabar? Or if it is real fur, then obviously that was the animal's coat, right? All of these things will have an impact on your well-being and the way you think, and that's why it's really important to consider a vegan lifestyle. Non-vegan materials that can be used in clothes and shoes include wool, cashmere, mohair, angora, leather, silk, down feathers, fur. If you don't know what any of them are, let me know in the chat and then I can respond later. Wool, just briefly, the most commonly raised sheep in the country, actually let's not go there, let's be a bit quicker. So the sheep that is reared the most for their wool are specifically bred to have wrinkly skin, and that makes them have more wool per animal, because it's all about the wool and not the animal, right? And that unnatural overload of wool causes many sheep to collapse from heat exhaustion during the hot months. Some die from it. On top of that, the wrinkles collect urine and moisture, and that attracts flies. Anybody flies there, any eggs lay kare in the folds of the skin, they hatch, become maggots, and they eat the sheep alive. So all of that is because of wool. To prevent this maggots business, ranchers use something called mulesing, and where they restrain the sheep, and without painkillers, they remove large chunks of their skin to make the skin smoother so that it doesn't collect moisture. But then open wounds can also attract the flies, because they don't then stitch them up. They don't care about the animal. And then, so therefore it's nishpar, and Yeah, like, do we need wool when there's so many other materials? So that's one, just to, if you're not sure about why wool is on the list, that's why. Leather, I'm sure you know that it's made from cows, pigs, goats, sheep, exotic animals such as alligators, ostriches, kangaroos, dogs, cats. In PETA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals in India, they found that workers break the cows' tails, rub chili peppers in their eyes and tobacco into their eyes in order to force them to get up when they collapse from exhaustion when they're on the way to the slaughterhouse. And the slaughterhouse is for mass and leather, right? It's all connected, dairy, everything. I'm not going to go into that. That's just a second. Okay, so buying leather directly contributes to factory farms and slaughterhouses, and the skin is a profitable byproduct of the meat industry. Leather is also destructive for the planet. This is something a lot of people don't know, and it shares responsibility for all the environmental destruction caused by the meat industry, as well as pollution, which is caused by the toxins used in tanning, which is part of the process when they make leather. Silkworms, I think a lot of you may know that it takes many, many silkworms to produce a little bit of silk. So if the silkworms, they weave the silk to make the cocoon, and if they're allowed to come out of the cocoon, they the silk will be broken because they bite it or tear it or whatever, so they can come out. So what they do is silk vadharwa mate. They boil or freeze them alive, which is what you can see in the picture, or steam them or gas them. But basically, they kill them while they're in their cocoon because the silk production vadi jai. And it takes 3,000 silkworms to make every pound of silk. So that's something that's, horrible. Down feathers, yes, it gives us warmth and comfort, and it's light, for example. Duvets that have feathers in them, they're really nice and light and they're warm, but they are feathers that basically are taken from the birds, as you can see in the picture. Down is basically the soft layer of feathers that's closest to the bird's skin, primarily in the chest region, and they're especially valued because they don't have quills. So you get more feather rather than the waist. Most down and other feathers are removed from the ducks and geese during slaughter. However, birds in breeding flocks and those raised for meat and foie gras may be plucked repeatedly while they're still alive, and that's why you can see them walking around with those pink patches. They're usually lifted by their necks or their delicate wings or their legs, they're restrained, and the feathers are pulled out without any painkillers or anything. And the plucking may begin when they're only 10 weeks old, and it's repeated every 6 weeks until the bird is slaughtered or until they naturally die. So, you know, all of this, like, is this something we want to be part of? Fur. 85% of the fur industry's skin comes from animals living captive in fur farms. Animals on farms spend their life confined to cramped, filthy wire cages. And to cut costs, the fur farmers pack animals into small cages to prevent them from taking more than a few steps back and forth. In order to save money when they slaughter them, they use poison or unfiltered engine exhaust fumes from a truck. Sometimes it's not even lethal, they're just knocked out. So then while they're being skinned, they wake up, and it's just, yeah, it's not very nice. I won't go into more detail than that, but that's why vegans wouldn't use fur. It's easy. The positive thing is it's easy to stop funding these industries. You can shop online or in stores, and you just need to read the label and check what it's made of. So it's really not a big deal. If you're not sure, ask a member of staff if it contains wool, leather, silk, feathers, fur. If you're buying online, you can ask for clarification. You can tweet the company, Facebook them, email them, use their contact form on their website. There are many ways to get in touch and ask them. And it's good because then the companies will know, yeah, we are looking out for these things. And then they will invest in finding alternatives, and they'll stop doing it or reduce doing it. So it's really good. And you see this picture in the middle where it says brand price, heel height, heel type, and then it says leather, no leather. So a lot of websites have a filter system where you can put when a leather ni vastu not choti, ke silk ni vastu not choti, or vegan vastu joiche. So that makes it really easy to shop. So it shouldn't be like a hard thing. In terms of clothes and shoes and bags, and not shoes, bags and accessories, all these places provide vegan clothes, bags and accessories for men and women. And there's many more that I've got on a list, which I can provide by email to share with you if you like. Buying vegan shoes, all these companies and more provide vegan shoes. And recently, New Look create, rather than it being vegan by accident, they actually have a vegan range. So lots of now companies are labeling their shoes vegan because they realize that people are thinking about it and looking out for it. Vegan cosmetics, without going into too much detail, they contain things like powdered insect bodies or fish scales that scraped off dead matchli, or protein that comes from the var, nuck or horns of mammals, lots of things. So if you don't want all those things in your cosmetics, then you can buy vegan cosmetics for men and women from these companies, and again, many more. Some of these are fully vegan, others have a vegan range, but it's really, really not difficult. And that's the bit I want to stress to you. Part of this talk is about sharing why vegans don't have certain food items and drink items and certain items like fur and things like that, why they don't buy them, but it's also showing you how easy it is to move away from those things and lead a vegan lifestyle. So yeah, vegan cosmetics is easy. And vegan cleaning products, I'm getting a bit faster because I realized the time. You can buy vegan cleaning products. These brands are vegan and you can buy them in Sainsbury's, Tesco, Asda, Holland and Barra. Astonish is available now actually in loads of supermarkets, but otherwise also in pound stores or those stores that sell anything and everything. So one, Monganati, two, easily available, three, they're vegan. So like Hinsawashu, right? And travel, this is something that may be at the forefront of your mind at the moment because we've been restricted from travel for quite a while. So some of the places I've been to and some that are on my wish list where I've been when I was vegan and I stayed vegan are Brighton, Glasgow, I want to go, Camden, I've been, Bath, Birmingham, Paris, Barcelona, Madrid, Malaga, amazing options, Zanzibar, Marrakesh, Dubai, St. Lucia, San Francisco, New York, all of those places I've been. And the things that were on my wish list are vegan river cruises and cruise and maritime voyages. They apparently have amazing vegan options. But yeah, really, really easy to travel and stay vegan and plant-based as well. So this is time for that question again. So I'm going to do the share gallery. Okay, so just give me a second. Okay, so I want to ask you the same questions that I asked you before, okay? So now your thought through response. Because we've talked about all these things, so you've got lots of content in your mind. So do you think going plant-based or vegan will have a positive or negative impact on the planet? So let's go with positive. Positive, yes. Positive, not sure. Positive, no. Okay, cool. Would living a vegan lifestyle save animals from captivity, harm, and death? Yes. No. I don't know. Okay. If you don't want to turn your video on, feel free to put it in the chat. I'm happy to have a look at that. Would this shift have a positive impact on you and yours? Yes. No. Not sure. Okay, cool. Does going plant-based improve our physical health based on what we've talked about so far? Yes, no, I don't know. Okay. Can going vegan or plant-based have a positive impact on our emotional well-being? Yes, no, I don't know. Okay. And last one, is performance and recovery improved when our diet is plant-based? Yes. No. Okay, cool. All right, so that shows me that some of your thinking has changed, which is very cool. Final bit is additional support if you want it. There's lots of free content on my website, which Vinodangal has shared in the chat. I have a recipe book, which is called The Way to a Vegan's Heart. And the recipes on purpose, I think all but one maybe, are 30 minutes from start to finish. Because gana na man mayam che ke vegan thaisne ke plant-based khaanu khaisne to maako di mandraso ru majo burse. It's not true. But the recipes are literally 30 minutes or less. And I offer one-to-one coaching to help people reduce the gap between what they're thinking and what they're doing, to reduce the duality and help them make the shift they want to make. So thank you very much. And I hope the talk was helpful. Sorry, I went a bit over time.
It's okay. Bahu sundar ma president Vinod bhai apno khas abar man se Vinod bhai Parekh.
Badane Jai Jinendra and Jai Krishna. I think so, Heena, we had a very interesting talk. There are some corners which we didn't knew. What was vegan? Many of them still don't know. We talk vegan, but they don't know what vegan is, what vegetarian is. So that was beautiful what you told us. Another thing was about the fiber, which everybody knows that the more we take, the better it is for a digestion and all that. The other thing was about the oil. I know oil is one of the biggest issues we have. But if we make a step forward, I think so we can do it. There are ways around it, but people seem to be either afraid or they don't want to move forward. But if they do it, I think so we can have a lot of change in our life with that. And another very interesting point which you showed us was the charcoal to use for the water. Mm. That was the first time I don't know, I might have heard, but I wasn't sure. But that's a good way of doing it instead of filling up the filter bottle and then just having it. This could help us a lot also. So that was another good point. You had some it was quite a number of points are there. I think so Vinubhai will share with us later on when we can send it to our members. So on behalf of our Kendra, all the members, I thank you very much for giving us your important time to with us and share your views. And I'm sure our members have learned a lot from that. If there is sometimes we get another chance, we might even call you and give you another opportunity to put us some more picture on vegan and all that. Wish you all the best. Another thing which we mentioned about the fur, I think so in England, there is a rule, government, that you can't use fur for any clothing or that. I think so they'll stop that long time, if I'm not mistaken. Is it?
No, there's definitely products you can buy with fur, and some things they label it as faux fur, which means fake fur, but actually isn't fake fur. They're just flooding the market with it.
Yeah.
So yeah, no, it's still
possible. Still there is a problem, and I think so. A lot of Englishmen, white men, they are now changing their attitude from meat to going to vegan because they're now understanding that by killing we are doing something ahimsa. No, that's I think so. That's a good point. I know it may take time, but it's coming up slowly among them also. So that was nice. Thank you very much. But then Jai Jindra, Jai Krishna.
Sorry, Uncle, just a quick thing. A few people have asked questions in the chat. So tame jet save money save karwa nahi de. Will you be able to save the chat and send it to me and then I can respond to the questions?
Khyal nahi how to say.
Basically, if you go to open the chat and you click on the three dots, it should let you save it. But it won't let me save it.
Three dots.
There are many or there are few?
There's quite a few. If you click on basically file all the three dots, it should let you save it. But
I'll try. Okay. Three dots. Oh, yes, three dots.
Yeah.
No, it's a stop live stream.
Oh, okay. I'll try and copy it.
Sorry, if then... you want to photograph it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll try and do that, and then I'll email.
And lots of good feedback, compliments, everything. And yes, very informative. One person has bought charcoal toothpaste. Very nice lecture. Yeah. Name of many. Sudha. Yeah, Pusha. And anybody else wants to ask anything?
Tabe pani filter karwa mare shu mukyu pani ma
charcoal sticks. Main article leku chhe tumne moklavi through Vinod uncle, and it will explain like how often it lasts and what you do with it after. It's really good, and it's not that expensive, and it lasts over 6 months.
Sabar ma kitla ek glass ke be glass pani piu saru ke pachi.
It depend. Kon puche? Sorry, mane.
Sudha, my wife. Yeah.
Oh, tiancho. Sorry, yeah. Hi. sorry, ata ma faces ata ne bana ko pei kon puche tu. Ichhe it depends on my health pramane also, because gana MK ke wo sawar na por mat just badu pi levano ne aku system flush thei jai. But like ek samte ek liter piwano or whatever. So what I would say to you is, any badle, even just having a glass in the morning, a glass just throughout the day, just keep having small amounts, rather than exam de atlu badu, small amounts throughout the day, any time of day, daytime, nighttime, whatever, it doesn't matter.
Exam tu ja pani pi etle kidney upar bahu asar thai ne, ane etle e to em ke chhe ki kidney apnu water filter karvu joiye, filter karya vagar jo pani emne ma aave to kidney ma problem thai jaye.
Absolutely.
Ha, chhe also the thing that what a lot of people are saying is, jo kok manso say ek vage ke bar vage je hoy ek time e ek liter aku pani pi jay, but eni pehla tame je vastu khadi hoy, the body hasn't had enough time to process it, ele je vastu body ne grahan karvi hoy e badu flush out thai jay, because you're forcing yourself to have a liter of water in one go. And also it doesn't keep you hydrated. The reva mate, you need to have water throughout the day, so that's why it's better to have a glass here or there, you know, just throughout the day. And em also ke yaad na re, cuz also ganana man che ne va thai gaya ke amne taras lagi hoy pan amne em thai ke amne bhook lagi che, but actually body ne pani ni jaru che, not khavanu le ame khada rakhe. So the body keeps saying, yeah, you're still hungry, but it's not, it actually wants water. So if that happens, you could try, when you think you'll feel hungry, but actually already khaili dushe enough, just have some water and see if it makes a difference. Because the body can only get a little bit of water from food. It gets more from, obviously, water itself. And if you keep either set an alarm to go off every hour, or you could keep like something like this in different places, one in the kitchen, one in the living room, one in the bedroom. It comes with this, or you know, tamai al na levo hoy to eni upar sani rakhi de ani whatever you want, etle dudiana jay andar, and then it will remind you to have water frequently.
A charcoal stick kya mase?
Anywhere, Amazon, eBay, tamai Google ma karso ni charcoal water filter sticks to tamne dekha se, and then hun jo ke mane chh ke at le lo exam te ne jasas to idea le lo, because they're the same thing anyway. So yeah,
ek ayurved case hai che guru em kese ke tamare dadab ni chhal che pani ma nakhvi ta to hard jarak nakhvi em judi judi rite judu judu tame pani piyo khali plain pani piyo ena karta e pani piyo to tamara sharir ne vadhar asar thay. I don't know how much it is true.
I don't know. Yeah, I'm not ayurved. I don't know. But definitely for those people who aren't having water, this is a good start.
Yes. Okay, thank you so much.
No problem.
Very nice, very informative.
Good.
And of course, bhaiyo tatha beno, video bajane apne share karishu, YouTube upar record karyu chhe. So obviously, you can share it with your family and friends and other people.
Thank you very much for the Zoom team doing a wonderful work, and a program committee for arranging this talk and everything. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yourself is very lively, so you have made the whole program very lively.
Very interesting.
Good, I'm glad. Good.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you.
Bye.
We might call you again sometime.
Sure.
Na gana loko aaya jo about 70.
Yeah, we had about 85 people. 85 people registered.
Ek ma be jonara hoy eu budhi.
Yeah, usually on YouTube ma hoy e batare. It's about 150.
Yeah.
So good. Many people took the advantage.
Very good.
Thank you.
Okay then. Bye.
Bye. Bye.